warm welcome to the DPRK, the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. The original name of Korea, Joseon, means the land of morning calm. From time immemorial, it has been called the land of golden tapestry for its world-famous mountains and scenic spots. All of you tourists would directly witness, hear, and experience real looks of Seongun, Korea, and cherish impressive memories of them.
This is the Grand Monument on Mansu Hill. The monument gives formative and artistic depiction of the immortal history of the revolutionary struggle waged by the Korean people under the leadership of the great Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il. It has bronze statues of the great Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il and large sculptural groups depicting the anti-Japanese armed struggle and the socialist revolution and socialist construction on both sides of the statues. The monument was unveiled in April 1972 on the occasion of the 60th anniversary of the birth of the great president Kim Il-sung. In April 2012, the bronze statues of the great Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il were solemnly unveiled on the occasion of the centenary anniversary of the birth of President Kim Il-sung, representing the unanimous desire of the Korean people. Behind the monument is the Korean Revolution Museum with a large mosaic mural of Mount Baekdu, the sacred mountain of revolution.
This is Tulima statue. In a Korean legend, Tulima is a winged horse that is said to cover 1,000 ri in a day. The statue was erected in April 1961 to symbolize the heroic spirit and the indomitable mettle of the Korean people who made rapid progress in the post-war rehabilitation and construction at the speed of Tulima. The statue is 46 meters high and 16 meters long. This is Panmunjom. Panmunjom lies on the military demarcation line of the Korean Peninsula. It witnesses the most serious tragedy of the division of the country and the most acute confrontation of war or peace. Panmunjom began to be known widely to the world when the US imperialists bent their knees to the Korean people in the Korean War and signed an armistice agreement. It attracts the attention of the world, and usually visitors to Korea call that Panmunjom. This is the conference room for ceasefire negotiation. In this room, ceasefire talk took place between the Korean People's Army and the US imperialists during the Korean War. The conference room is 1 kilometer south from the northern border of the demilitarized zone. Now in the room, there are preserved the table and chairs used by the senior and other delegates of the Korean and US sides as they were. The armistice talk took place between July 10, 1951 and July 19, 1953. This is the building for signing the armistice agreement. When the armistice talk reached an agreement on ceasefire and its machinery, the US side proposed holding a ceremony of signing the armistice agreement quietly in a temporary tent out of door. It was because the US imperialists were afraid that future generations might see the place where they signed a surrender document after suffering shameful defeat in the Korean War. In defiance of the sinister intention of the US imperialists, the Democratic People's Republic of Korea saw to it that the building with an area of over 200 square meters was set up in 5 days, and so the ceremony of signing the armistice agreement was held here. As a result, this building remains as a witness of history. In the building, there are preserved the table of signing the armistice agreement chairs, flags, documents, and other materials. This is monumental stone inscribed with an autograph of respected President Kim Il-sung. It was erected to immortalize the historic date of July 7, 1994, the last day of his life, when he put his signature on the last document on national reunification and died at his post. This is Conference Room District. In front of Panmun Pavilion, a building of the DPRK, there stand seven buildings, which were used as conference rooms of the Military Armistice Commission and the Neutral Nations Supervisory Commission in the past. In the center of the building, there stands a table crosswise, and on the table, there are lying microphones along its middle line. Just it is the military demarcation line, a symbol of Korea's division. Between the buildings, a 40 centimeter wide and 7 centimeter high concrete marker is laid in a line with microphones in the building, thereby forming the demarcation line. The military demarcation line is 246 kilometers long in total. This is concrete wall.